guys, it's Morgan coming to you with another race video. We are at Pajarito Ski Area, just up above Los Alamos, New Mexico, for the final round of the Weeby Hare Scrambles. It's gonna be awesome. I'm getting ready to go team racing. I'm not gonna video the team race. There's three of us, me, my kid Ewan, and my buddy Andy, who just put that Smart Carb and Recluse into his YZ 250. So this is gonna be awesome. It's a really tough course, guys. So I will check back in after the team race and let you know how we did, and then we're gonna go racing tomorrow. So guys, that didn't quite go as I had hoped. I'm honestly relatively embarrassed to be even making this video, but I feel like you guys deserve an explanation. All my sponsors deserve an explanation as to what happened and why I wasn't able to race on Sunday at the last round of the Weeby Hare Scrambles. So here we're coming with a race report for the weekend. And actually, there are some positive notes, but for me personally, it just did not go like I had hoped. We got to Pajarito, which is a ski resort just up above Los Alamos, New Mexico, an absolutely drop-dead gorgeous part of the country. So we got there the morning of the race, got everything set up, went up to do practice, had a great practice run. My son Ewan was racing his KX100. My son Thomas decided he didn't want to race. He was just going to hang out and help pit for us. We had a good practice. Ewan struggled a little bit on some of the big hill climbs. There's some really, really big hill climbs and really loose, rocky stuff. But he did great, actually. He just had a couple problems, but was able to deal with it all himself. So we were going to team race together with my buddy Andy Thompson. And we got all ready to go. I was going to take off first because we could race the C class since I'm an A rider, and then I had two C riders on the team. We could race the C class. So I figured I'd take off and hopefully jump out front, which I did. Had a great start. Got out in first pretty quickly, and then was really just having fun riding. I felt like completely under control. Bike was working perfectly. Tires were perfect. Mooses were perfect. Suspension was perfect. The motor was amazing. The head, RKTech head, had that bike just grunting up the hills, running perfectly. I put a huge gap on the guys behind me, started catching people from the line in front of me, just having a ton of fun. The weather was perfect. I mean, seriously, everything was lining up to be just a really fun team race. I was going to get the bike back to my buddy Andy, and he was going to give the bike to Ewan. And yeah, we're just going to have a blast. And then at some point during that lap, and you'll notice I said some point, I really don't know exactly when. I do remember the crash, sort of. I don't remember where it was on the course. I don't remember exactly everything about it, but I was coming downhill fast and then making a turn into the trees to kind of shoot through the trees and over to another run, another side hill. And I made the turn, and the ski hill is full of rolly rocks. And I knew that. I'd been around it once before. I've raced there before. It's like nothing, no surprise, right? And I hit one with my front tire, and the bike just disappeared from underneath me. Not a problem with the suspension, not a problem with the tires, just a mistake by me putting the bike on a rock that I knew could be rolly. As that happened, I exited the bike, which, you know, we've all done that if we've raced dirt bikes or ridden dirt bikes very long. Usually not a big deal, but it was like diving down a hill. And as that happened, I was tucking my arms in because I was like, oh, this is going to be bad. I was going really fast. And as I did that, I landed, and my body was like, if this is my head, my body went whack, and my head hit the ground really, 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 really hard. And I immediately like jumped up, and I couldn't focus on the bike. I couldn't see the bike. I was blinking and blinking and trying to get focus. And I realized, oh boy, this is not good. I got the bike up. My vision came back. And then things started. That's when things get fuzzy. I don't really remember anything. I remember getting on the bike and taking off and wondering where everybody was, because I figured people would have passed me because I didn't really know how long I was laying there. Anyway, I got on the bike, I got going, and then, like I said, this is where things get a little fuzzy. I don't really remember the rest of the course back to the pits. I remember parts of it, and then not parts of it, and then the next thing I can really be sure of is my family asking me, who are you racing with? And me saying, that's a problem. And I, at that moment, I started to remember things and remember what had happened. I guess in the interim, I had come into the pits flying. My kids and my wife said I was absolutely moving on the course. I put in a heater of a lap, like my lap time was really fast. I came in, changed the scrunchie off. They have like little scrunchies on your arm that you change off for a team race. And my other guy took off and they looked at me and I was kind of looking weird. And I started asking them questions like, oh, did John come in? You know, Johnny Conroy, my buddy, who I had passed at the first of the race. And he's like, they're like, no. Well, I guess I started asking those questions lots of times and they kept answering them and I kept not remembering the answers. So they immediately knew something was wrong. So they called the medics. They came up. They got me. Buddy Jared Renner, thank you, Jared, took my bike down to the pits for me. Took me to the ambulance. At this point, I started really remembering things, and things started being clearer, and I could remember answers I'd given and all that stuff. I was checked out at the ambulance. Great ambulance crew. Thank you guys so much that was there at Pajarito. I really appreciate that. And thank you. Huge thank you to Weeby Racing. You guys just did a great job. So anyway. And the ambulance guy said, Morgan, I think, you know, honestly, I don't think you really need to go to the hospital. I think you're okay. You seem to be clearing up. It's up to you. He's like, my recommendation is that you get checked out, but it's, I'm going to leave it in your hands and your wife's hands. So my wife and I decided that we wouldn't go to the hospital, but that she would keep a real good eye on me. It was still early enough in the day that we could go get dinner. We could hang out, not go to sleep for a while. You know, so she decided, like, okay, let's just go down into town and hang out. So we did that. I didn't get any worse. Everything was fine. Sadly, it set me up to make the decision to not race the next day. I was banged up a little bit. I had my thigh hurt some and my back. I must have hurt a rib or something in the back. Anyway, obviously I hit the ground really hard, but honestly, everything else was fine. The bike, for anyone who's wondering, is totally okay. The brand new pipe that I just put on is also okay. Amazingly enough, it didn't even get scratched. I did bend a radiator back a little bit, but thanks, huge thanks to Bulletproof Designs, one of our sponsors, because the radiator, all it did was bend back a little bit. It didn't crush it at all. It was totally fine. But I made the decision not to race because it's, they're finding, the science is showing that it's really, really, really bad if you hit your head a second or third time after a concussion. It's like really bad for you. I mean, it's why all the NFL players are having problems. It's why my good friend Roger Hurd, they suspect that his Parkinson's, his early onset Parkinson's, is from numerous head injuries and not letting them heal. So I made the really, really tough decision not to race. And that was tough because I was set up to win the 40A championship. And I know it's just the Weeby Hair Scramble series. I know it's not a huge series. I know it's not that big of a deal, but it was a big deal to me because I've never won a championship. I've actually never raced a whole series before. And I'm honestly racing better this year than I have ever. I'm 46 years old now and I'm racing better than I've ever raced before. So it was really, really hard for me to do that. But I knew it was the best decision for me personally in my head and for my family and, you know, for my racing career. It's not really a career, but I knew it was a better decision. I also really struggled because I knew that you guys here that watch this on YouTube like watching my race videos, but also you guys are rooting for me. And I really, really appreciate that. And I am so sorry that I let you guys down. I'm sorry to all the people who sponsor us. Super sorry to Nitro Moose, Jeff Douglas. I'm so sorry. He sent me a brand new moose to get me rolling for the race, a front moose, and I botched it, Jeff. I'm sorry, man. I really feel bad about that. I know probably a lot of people are going to say, oh, you know, you did the right, I know I did the right thing. I just am sorry because I hate to let people down. But let's move on to the upside of this thing. And sadly, I don't have any footage, any film from anything. So sorry about this story time situation, but anyway, the best part of the weekend. My son Ewan, who's 12, rides KX100. I was really worried that he was going to be worried about, you know, I crashed and all the stuff and the course was hard. I was worried he was just not going to want to race. But as the night went on, Saturday night, he was just more and more fired up and telling me how he was going to race, what his strategy was, all this stuff. And I'm like, yes. We get out there Sunday morning. It's cold, man. Like, I don't know, 30-something degrees. Well, it's probably lower than that. It's frost on the ground. Anyway, get out there. He's ready to rock and roll, man. I get him all set up. He lines up in the Iron Mini class. There's like six kids. And one of the kids is like, I think he drove there. He's like, I don't know. I think he's 15. I'm pretty sure he's 15. He's full-size kid, but he's riding this 85, and he's really, really fast anyway. And then the rest of them are all more like Ewan-sized. I was like, oh boy, that's going to be tough. And these other kids all had these fancy KTMs and all this stuff, and there's Ewan on his KX100, which is a nice bike, don't get me wrong, but again, fancy KTM stuff. They took off. He got a great start. And as they come around, the old kid, the one who's shaving, he came around. I'm just kidding, by the way. But he came around and in first, as we all expected. He's, like I said, he's a great kid, awesome kid. He's well within the rules, so I'm just giving him a hard time. He came around first, and I thought, okay, that's great. We'll see where Ewan comes around. And lo and behold, not that terribly long after, here comes Ewan in second place. I was like, yes! And fired up, man. He came through the pits on the gas, pinned. Once he saw us, you know, he got all fired, like looking good. Was really, really, really happy for him. But again, he had to do more laps, and it's like the course is hard and rolly rocks, and there's a lot of things that can catch you, like the thing that got me. The kid first came around and got another lap because he was really moving. And then they started throwing the checkers, and here comes Ewan, still in second place. I was ecstatic. Absolutely ecstatic for him, and he was so happy. When I told him that I thought he was in second, he was just ear-to-ear grin, so proud of himself. It was awesome. I was so happy for him. It just made my heart sing, you know, and it really just like eliminated and deleted all the crap about me not getting to race and letting people down, all this stuff. It all just disappeared. I didn't care about any of that. All I cared about was this kid and how great he did. And his brother was doing so great pitting. He was cheering and yelling and screaming and making sure everything was good. And he helped him get the bike ready. I was just so happy to watch my family come together behind you and then have it be a success. It was so cool. So yeah, it was just a great weekend. I'm bummed about my situation, but you know, I'm here, I get to race again, I'll be fine. Huge, huge thank you to Weeby Racing. Chelsea and James, thank you guys so much. All the people who work at those races, I know you guys are all volunteers. Thank you so much. Thank you to the medical crew. Thank you to all the course workers. Thank you to all the sponsors of Weeby and of me. I don't have it all memorized, and it'll all be in the link in the description. All the people who helped sponsor us and support us, please buy stuff from them. Please buy stuff from them. If you want to, tell them you heard about them from us. I don't really care. Just help them out. It's important to me. So anyway, guys, I love you so much. Thank you for sticking around for this funny, weird video. Not like my normal thing, but I hope you enjoyed it. If you did, give us a thumbs up, maybe share it with a friend. Also, quick note on head injuries. Please, please, please take them seriously. My very good friend Roger, like I said, is suffering from early onset Parkinson's, most likely because of a head injury. Take them seriously. Let your head heal. Don't do stupid things in the name of a race or a series or whatever. I love you guys. I hope you get out and spread the gospel of two wheels. And as always, I desperately hope that what we're doing here at Highland Cycles is inspiring you guys to work on and get out and ride your dirt bikes!